Toxic masculinity. What is it? This trending term is derived from Gillette's We Believe short film that aims at challenging men to take action in doing their part to reduce bullying and harassment. Unfortunately, many men are taking this video as an attack on male masculinity in general, and that Gillette is attempting to redefine men as this new pushover pussy gender with no balls. I'm curious as to why men are taking offense to this video, because in what world is it acceptable to either partake in or be a bystander to bullying and harassment? Taking offense means that you view this behavior as an acceptable and necessary component of shaping boys into a masculine male role. How does bullying and harassment help to define male masculinity? If we're talking about having a pair, then it takes a lot more courage to stand up against bullying and harassment. I understand that one of the main counter-arguments may be that there's too much sheltering going on in our society. And you know what? I completely agree with that. This is a major issue, but it has nothing to do with this video. In fact, quite the opposite, since in the video, Gillette is trying to encourage men to be role models for boys, teaching them morals and respect. I believe that bullying and harassment goes hand in hand with victim blaming. As a victim of abuse, I cannot speak enough towards how much it hurts when those that you place your trust in paint you as either deserving, lying, or exaggerating the circumstances of the event. Boys will be boys, right? The point of my video is to defend and explain the morals of the Gillette video. Bullying and harassment does not define male masculinity, and the absence of those behaviors does not make us any less of a man. Being a bystander to those behaviors, despite how awkward you may feel, is also not acceptable either. Be a real man and stand up against bullying and harassment, as well as listening to victims. Thank you.